जय हिंद कैडेट्स, वेलकम इन दिस सेशन। दिस इज पार्ट 4 ऑफ मैजिक ट्रिक्स ऑन जंबल सेंटेंसेस फॉर एनडीए एंड एनए एग्जामिनेशन। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सम इम्पोर्टेंट सिंटैक्स टाइप्स, एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ जंबल सेंटेंसेस विच अपीयर्ड इन एनडीए एग्जामिनेशन एंड सम ट्रिक्स टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस ऑन जंबल सेंटेंसेस। दीज आर द सिंटैक्स टाइप्स विच वी ऑलरेडी लर्न इन द अर्लियर सेशंस, बट आई हैव गिवन यू फॉर योर क्विक रिविजन। As you can see that in any kind of sentence, the first part is subject, okay, except interrogative sentences and some other structures, okay, and the last part is object, complement or adverbial, okay, and after the subject, a verb is used, and sometimes between the subject and the verb, as you can see in the second structure, between the subject and the verb, a phrase can be inserted. As you can see in the third syntax type, between the subject and the verb, a clause can be inserted. A clause can be introduced with a relative pronoun such as who. And sometimes two verbs can be joined by and as well as not only but also etc. So these structures might confuse us. So we must be careful about them. And sometimes two subjects can be combined, can be joined together, and the same verb can be used for both of them. So these are the various syntax types, and apart from these syntax types, there are so many others, but these are some of the most common and frequently used syntax types. So let's begin with the questions. This is the first question. Here we have five parts of a sentence. The first part, the sentence begins with a very old man. You can see that a very old man is a noun phrase which is used as a subject in the beginning of the sentence, and obviously after the subject we use a verb. Okay, so with a wrinkled face and a long beard. So here, with a wrinkled face and long beard is a phrase which is modifying this noun man. Okay, so it is also a part of the subject. A very old man with a wrinkled face and a long beard. Okay. So this phrase is a part of a modifier. It is working as a modifier to modify this noun head word in the noun phrase man. What kind of man are we talking about? A very old man who is having a wrinkled face and a long beard. And so this is the complete subject now with a modifier also in the some modifiers in the beginning and some modifiers after the noun head word noun. Okay, so after this detailed subject, we surely need to have a verb. Okay, and the verb is in the last part of the sentence. A very old man with a wrinkled face and a long beard married. Whom did he marry? Here we need to have a noun phrase as an object. A pretty girl. Okay, of 16. Of 16 means a pretty girl who was of 16 years age. Okay, so R will come in the end. So our sequence forms as P S Q R. P S Q R. This is the option. Option A is the answer in this question. Now let's go to the next question. Here we have a sentence which is split into only four parts, unlike the earlier example where the sentence was split into five parts. Sometimes this kind also can appear. Sham took. See, Sham is a noun phrase which is a subject and took is the verb. Okay. A photograph. Sentence obviously need not begin with a photograph. A person is mentioned here. He took something. He took a photograph. Okay. Sham took a photograph from the window which was overexposed. Actually, see, which is a relative, which is a what we call relative pronoun. Okay. Which is used as a conjunction. Okay. To start a new clause, to introduce a new clause. Now you can see that what is exactly overexposed. The window is not overexposed. The photo is overexposed. So the clause which is introduced with which should appear after a photograph. Okay. So Sham took a photograph which was overexposed. Okay. Sham took a photograph which was overexposed. See, this which is used for this photograph. The photograph was overexposed. Okay, and where do we need to use this now? From the window, we can use it immediately after the verb. Okay, Sham took from the window a photograph which was overexposed. So our sequence forms PRQS. Okay, if you look at the options, PRQS is the third option, option C. Okay, so here is the answer, option C, PRQS. Okay, that's all about question number two. Now let's go to question number three. This is question number three, and here we are going to talk about climate change. And the sentence is split into five parts, and the first part is a noun free noun. Okay, and a noun can be a subject, and obviously it is a subject. Here we don't find any question mark. Yes, this is a different part. Okay, in all the four parts we don't find any question mark. Okay, it is not a question interrogative sentence, it is not exclamatory sentence also. It's an assertive sentence which obviously needs to begin with a subject, and so subject is given in the beginning. Climate change is a frequently used noun phrase. Climate change is truly unifying phenomenon. What kind of phenomenon is it? It unifies almost every section of society. Okay, almost every section of humanity. Climate change is truly a unifying phenomenon. So it's, our answer should obviously begin with R. Okay. So here we have two options. We can eliminate remaining two options, so which begin with P. So PSQR or PQSR. Okay. So after P, R, R, RSQP or RQSP. So R के बाद में S आएगा या Q आएगा ये हमें decide करना है. अभी R तो सबसे पहले आएगा. Climate change is truly unifying phenomenon. अभी हमें दो options देखना है, S and Q. S है world irrespective of national boundaries. डायरेक्टली ये फ्रेज नहीं आएगा, तो इट डज नॉट मैच इन द सीक्वेंस. ओके, सो आई थिंक क्यू शुड बी देयर इन दैट. ओके, व्हाई इज इट ट्रूली यूनिफाइंग फिनोमिनन? इन दैट मीन्स बिकॉज इन दैट इट अफेक्ट्स द एंटायर वर्ल्ड. इन दैट इट अफेक्ट्स द एंटायर वर्ल्ड. क्यू एस शुड अपियर देन. सो यू कैन सी इन ऑप्शन सी, आर के बाद में क्यू एस दिया गया है, तो और सबसे लास्ट में पी ए. ओके, क्लाइमेट चेंज इज ट्रूली यूनिफाइंग फिनोमिनन. इन दैट इट अफेक्ट्स द एंटायर वर्ल्ड इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ नेशनल बाउंड्रीज, कल्चर्स एंड पॉलिटिकल स्ट्रक्चर्स. सो आवर आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी. दैट्स ऑल अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री. नाउ लेट्स गो टू क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर. So this is question number four. Here also the sentence is split into five parts. Physical training, this is a noun phrase. After this we need a verb. The character of is not a verb. Who should not come with physical training, because it is not the name of a person. Can shape well. Yes, can shape is the verb. Physical training can shape well. What can it shape? It can shape the character of young boys and girls. Okay. Physical training can shape well the character of young boys and girls. Who? See, young boys and girls, these are persons. So the relative pronoun who should obviously come follow this. Okay, physical training can shape well the character of young boys and girls who are going to be responsible citizens. So Q should come in the end. So the sequence forms, the correct sequence forms seems to be R, P, S and Q. R, P, S, Q is option A. If you can see here, option A has this sequence, R, P, S, Q. So this is the answer. Now let's go to next question, question number five. Here again we have five parts. The sentence is split into five parts, and we can see that his favorite subject. His favorite subject is again a noun phrase which seems to be here the subject. Okay, because the subject should appear in the beginning, and subject can be a noun phrase or a pronoun. Okay, his favorite subject. Here we need a verb after the subject. Okay, here we have the verb happens to be. Happens is the verb. His favorite subject happens to be science. Uska favorite subject kya hai? Science hai. Kyunki? Because science reveals, kya reveal karta hai science? The secrets of life and of nature. Which men did not know in the past. जो secrets इंसानों को पहले पता नहीं थे. Okay, so our sequence forms as R comes in the beginning, then P for Q follows, R Q P and then S. R Q P S is option B. So our answer is option B. That's all about question number five. Now let's go to question number six. Here again, we have a sentence which is split into five parts. And the first one is nations of the world. This is a noun phrase. And here the head word is nations. And of the world is a modifier. Okay. Nations. Kaun se nations? Of the world. Duniya ke sare nations. So of the world is working, is this prepositional phrase is working as a modifier, which follows this noun. Okay. Nations of the world. This is the noun and this is the subject. And now we need a verb. Are making efforts. Are making. This is the verb in present continuous tense. Nations of the world are making efforts in developing peaceful international relation. As means because. As they are fully aware of. Aware ke baad mein hamesha of aata hai. As they are fully aware of the danger of their not coming together. Okay. So our sequence seems forms so as Q S P R. Q S P R is option C. Option C is Q S P R. So our answer is option C. That's all about question number six. Now let's go to the next question. Question number seven. George Bernard Shaw was a very popular literary figure, and we have this statement is about George Bernard Shaw. This is the subject we are talking about George Bernard Shaw, and considered is the verb. And after this verb, we need an object. What did he consider? He considered current English spelling. उन्होंने क्या किया? Current English spelling जो थी, उसका अच्छे से रिसर्च किया उन्होंने. ओके, ही कंसिडर्ड करंट इंग्लिश स्पेलिंग एंड और क्या किया उन्होंने? इन हिज विल, उनकी मृत्यु पत्र में उन्होंने क्या पीछे छोड़ गए? एंड इन हिज विल लेफ्ट बिहाइंड अ कंसिडरेबल पोर्शन ऑफ हिज वेल्थ, उनकी संपत्ति का बहुत सारा हिस्सा उन्होंने वो पीछे छोड़ गए. किस लिए? फॉर रिफॉर्म्स इन स्पेलिंग. इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज की स्पेलिंग में जो रिसर्च रिफॉर्म्स के लिए रिसर्च होता है, उस रिसर्च के लिए उन्होंने कंसिडरेबल पोर्शन ऑफ हिज वेल्थ ही लेफ्ट बिहाइंड इन हिज वेल्थ. सो आवर सीक्वेंस फॉर्म्स टू बी आर क्यू पी एंड एस. आर क्यू पी एस, वेर इज इट? आर क्यू पी एस इज ऑप्शन बी. सो आवर आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी. नाउ लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर एट. हियर वी हैव अ डिफरेंट फॉर्मेट. अनलाइक द अर्लियर क्वेश्चन, द सेंटेंस इज नॉट स्प्लिट इंटू फाइव पार्ट्स. इट इज स्प्लिट इंटू ओनली फोर पार्ट्स. ओके, व्हेन अ केमिकल सब्सटेंस, सी हियर वी हैव अ नाउन फ्रेज इन क्वेश्चन नंबर इन पार्ट क्यू. सो वील हैव टू टेस्ट इट बिकॉज अ सेंटेंस जनरली बिगिंस विद अ नाउन फ्रेज विच इज अ सब्जेक्ट. ओके, द फूड पॉइजनिंग ऑकर्ड. ऑकर्ड इज द वर्ब विच इज यूज आफ्टर दिस नाउन फ्रेज. The food poisoning occurred when a chemical substance was mistaken for salt and used in the food preparations. It's a very simple question. So our sequence happens to be QPSR. QPSR, where is it? QPSR is option B. So this is question number eight, and our answer is option B, QPSR. Now let's see the last but one question in this today's session. And here again we have five parts of the sentence. Even today in many countries, see, this is not a subject actually. Even today in many countries is a phrase. Now we need a subject and then a verb. Neglected is the verb. Who is a relative pronoun which should not come here? Few women, fewer women than when, so this should not come. Obviously, women should come here. Okay. Even today in many countries, women continue to be. Continue is verb. Women is subject. Okay. So we need a subject and then we need a verb. Even today in many countries, women continue to be neglected, and there are fewer women than men who have had the benefit of education and vocational training. Actually, the sentence is split into six parts. And this is the first part, even today in many countries, and the last part is and the last part is education and vocational training. So our sequence happens to be Q P S R. Q P S R is option B. So our answer is option B, Q P S R. Now let's look at the last question in today's session. Here we have five parts of the sentence. I have the habit. See, here I is the subject, have is the verb, the habit. Habit is the object. Which habit? Particular habit the writer is talking about. So here we need to use of. I have the habit of leaving my seat. मुझे मेरी सीट छोड़ने की आदत है. I have the habit of leaving my seat. लेकिन कब? As soon as it comes, see, and waiting at the door of the bus. मुझे क्या आदत है? मेरी सीट से उठ के बस के डोर की तरफ पास खड़े होके वेट करने की मुझे आदत है. I have the habit of leaving my seat and waiting at the door of the bus. As soon as it comes to the stop, so as to be able to get down. Okay. So as to be able to get down will come before as soon as it comes to the stop. So our sentence should end with S. Okay. So our sequence happens to be R, Q, P, S. And RQPS is option B. Again, our frequently answered B is coming. So this can happen in many of the questions. Okay. So that's all about this session. Contact us at the email ID which is provided here. You can also contact us at any of the given phone numbers for any query if you have. And for more information about the Defense Career Academy, you can visit us at this dcaurangabad.org, this website. Don't forget to follow us on various social platforms including Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube and WhatsApp. And that's all for now. Thank you. Have a nice day.